Every year, millions of animals are forced into the exotic pet trade for the purpose of becoming someone's pet or entertainment. Many of these animals grow up and become ferocious predators or too large to care for. In many cases, these unwanted animals are either released from their cages or euthanized. While some wild pets have been bred in captivity, many of them are plucked directly from their native habitats. The stress of being violently removed from their homes often causes them to die before they ever reach their destination. When trappers smuggle these animals into the United States, they endure grueling transport conditions.
My name is Lori Gagan, and I am the executive director at Black Pine Animal Sanctuary. Our mission is to provide refuge to displaced exotic animals for the rest of their lives and to educate people about responsible pet ownership. The trade of exotic animals in America is a multi-billion dollar industry. Much of the industry is legal, but there are illegal elements to it as well. And the basic value of the trade of exotic animals in this country is second only to drugs and guns.
These exotic animals are closer to your home than you might believe. Lori Gagan has the story.
We have a North American alligator. His name is Gus, and Gus was allegedly purchased in a pet store that's no longer in operation down in the central part of Indiana by a student who is attending Indiana University in Bloomington. And our understanding is the alligator was kept as a pet in the frat house where he lived for 2 or 3 years.
Exotic backyard breeders have fueled the exotic trade industry. These breeders only require a permit for breeding and often do not care about the animal's living conditions or their overall health. These animals are often cute and appealing as babies, but eventually grow into dangerous adults with unmanageable needs. When people can no longer afford to care for these animals or fail to find them a new home, they release them into the wild, endangering everyone. Several organizations around the country have made it their mission to take in as many of these unwanted exotic animals as they can provide for.
If we can improve an animal's life, then we do that. And a lot of times it comes down to whether that animal's going to face being euthanized if somebody doesn't step in and help. So some of the animals who live here seem to not have any options outside of being humanely euthanized. There are many, many animals who live here who have been surrendered voluntarily by people who were keeping them. We have 3 tigers that were living among 37 adult cats in a backyard compound that I have been known to compare to a puppy mill, only it was a tiger mill. It was a tiger breeding operation in southern Indiana. And over the course of 20, 25 years, this private breeder had legally bred probably well over 150 cats. So in those situations, you know, it's hard to say exactly what would have happened if we weren't able to help. We don't know if they had exhausted every opportunity. But hopefully euthanasia is a very, very last resort for any of these animals.
Unfortunately, in 2011, there was the biggest exotic animal release and massacre to occur in history.
As more than 50 lions, Bengal tigers, and bears roamed the streets, residents locking their homes, children kept behind closed doors. The animals were unleashed on the town by a suicidal man who kept them in his backyard. And ABC's David Curley spent the day following this inconceivable story and the animal scouts who had to track wild prey in Zanesville, Ohio.
This sign perfectly captured the fear that gripped this small Ohio town today. Exotic animals, wild animals on the loose. What may be the biggest release of dangerous carnivores in U.S. history. Deputies with shoot-to-kill orders used their pistols to take down lions, tigers, bears, and wolves before the sun went down. When it was over, 49 animals had been killed, including 18 Bengal tigers. Ohio has more incidents with exotic animals than any other state. Its laws are among the most lenient in the country.
Part of what we do, the rescue side of things and the animal welfare side of things, is that because there are not blanket laws that apply across the country, there are not very good statistics. People aren't required to register or disclose ownership of a lot of the types of animals that you'll see living at Black Pine. And because they're not required to register or license or things like that, we really don't know how big the problem is.
This industry is violent and gruesome, but it would not exist if people stopped supporting it. The reality is that we are the ones fueling the industry. We are the ones buying these exotic pets, and we are the ones paying to see them perform, unaware of the unfortunate lives that they live. If you would like to help the exotic animal trade, you can get involved by becoming an activist, stop supporting these exotic animal venues, and stop buying these exotic pets.